Let's talk about periods, a critical analysis of menstrual inequity in Canada. The impact of menstrual inequity is greater on marginalized groups and people who can't afford to purchase menstrual supplies. Now, this topic is steeped in myths and silence, and the stigma associated with menstruation meant that for decades, people did not publicly share the need for menstrual supplies. This led menstrual inequities to become a hidden problem in our society until recently. We spoke to 27 stakeholders, surveyed 100 Canadians to investigate these issues in Canada. We chose Canada because we've been advocating for menstrual equity here for the last 3 years, placing us in a position to make tangible changes with this research. Our systems map contains 6 stakeholder groups and how they interact with each other to maintain the status quo. These two challenges influence the interactions between the governing bodies and the community members, making them the two key stakeholder groups. Community members are the most powerful drivers of change and can influence legislation. So this lack of awareness means that these issues are never brought to the table for discussion. Governing bodies control how resources are allocated. And by restricting the resources, such as staff and funding, systemic barriers to achieving menstrual equity are created. Community members without access to menstrual supplies rely on NGOs for support. But with limited resources, NGOs can't meet this demand. And governmental agencies, such as local health authorities, do not have the necessary directives to take action on their own. So what are the solutions? Last year, new policies to provide free menstrual supplies in schools were introduced in several provinces. However, this intervention does not benefit marginalized groups that are the most affected, as they may not be attending schools at all. Campaigns where period products are collected and donated to those who can't afford it have also been very successful. However, this is dependent on community donations, which are limited and not effective in the long term. Community events and social media campaigns exploring this topic have become more popular. However, non-menstruating members are often left out of the conversation and as a result don't understand what period poverty really is.
What are the gaps in the current solutions? The first gap is that there is lack of collaboration and competition for resources, making advocacy very inefficient. A lever of change for this would be to make a central repository that contains updated information on menstrual equity advocacy. Also, a national committee should be upheld that represents advocacy groups from each province and region to help maintain the repository and streamline advocacy efforts. Our second gap is that interventions are not reaching marginalized groups. We propose to make intervention strategies with consultation from the group members themselves, ensuring that their menstrual needs are sufficiently met while preserving beliefs. Secondly, campaign materials should use inclusive terms such as people who menstruate, as opposed to the traditional gender-oriented statements that focus on females as the only menstruators. We also have lack of communication with non-menstruators. Our survey shows that half of the non-menstruators don't understand what menstrual equity is, and 77% of them don't understand the term period poverty. We propose to have distribution of educational and awareness materials that includes non-menstruating members of the community. Our research shows that non-menstruators are supportive of the movement when they are provided with the right information. We should also integrate menstrual education in the sex ed programming for schools, creating opportunities for students of all genders to engage in this conversation at a younger age will normalize periods. We also have a gap of budget reallocation. Currently, the majority of the budget is allocated towards just providing free period products, especially in schools and campuses. We need to have holistic research that includes the experiences and needs of marginalized groups, and funding should be allocated towards these research projects that explore a holistic solution to promoting menstrual equity. We also need subsidy programs. Currently, Quebec is the only province that has taken an initiative to provide menstrual cups at a subsidized cost. As advocates of menstrual equity, we have focused much of our work on providing free menstrual supplies. However, we now recognize that this issue is much more complex and a concerted effort by stakeholder groups is required. Interventions must address the needs of marginalized populations and should involve both menstruators and non-menstruators. While governing bodies play an imperative role, community members hold the power to influence these decisions and should be educated in menstrual equity to do so. Our study is limited by our sample size, the available literature, and information and selection biases. We hope that this research will help us take another step towards achieving menstrual equity in Canada.